Let's look at a few practical ways you can adjust your video to match with the audio and narration. The options I'm going to lay out will be good to help you get going, but definitely aren't the only ways to get your video better fit together. So, what do you do if you have more audio and narration than screen content? Well, this isn't unusual. A lot of times, it may take you longer to say something than to actually do it. When this is the case, you have a couple of options. The first option is to use something like extend frame. Extend frame is when you take a single frame and duplicate it on the timeline. Some programs will do this easily. In other cases, you may need to take a screenshot and add it to your timeline. Because the extended frame is still an image and not a video, it's highly flexible and can be extended as long as necessary to fill the gap. Remember though, that you may want to limit the length, as it can be boring to watch. And if it goes too long, the viewer may think that the video has become frozen. A second option is to switch to your camera recording if you have one. This will allow you to engage with your audience. You shouldn't use it to cover up anything crucial that your viewer needs to see, but if done well, it can help fill in the gaps. So if you're explaining the location of an item on the screen, you probably wouldn't want to switch to your webcam. A third option is to record more content or use B-roll footage to fill in the gaps. B-roll footage is video footage that supports the content but is not the main footage. For instance, if you're talking about software for a machine or a system, and you show video of that machine, system, or other contextual information, that's B-roll. Again, you won't want to hide the screen if you're narrating about something the viewer needs to see. Another, but different problem you may encounter is that the narration or the audio takes less time than the video. In this case, you may want or need to cut out anything non-essential. You may consider cutting out parts of the video that won't leave the viewer confused about what is happening. For instance, it's okay to cut out loading screens, obvious processes like typing in login information, or anything else that can be clearly understood without seeing it. Although, be careful to not cut too much, as you don't want to disorient the viewer by skipping essential steps or information. The next option to consider is speeding up the video playback in your editor. This will have the effect of increasing the speed of the video, shortening the length to better fit your audio. As you speed up part of your video, keep these things in mind. If you have audio connected to the clip, make sure you're not changing the audio speed as well. Next, speeding up a clip can make it difficult to watch and potentially hard to follow. If it's too fast or not planned well, your viewers may not be able to follow along or understand what you're sharing. Next up, let's move beyond cutting and fixing, and let's look at other enhancements you can add during the editing process to start enhancing your screencasts.